Well, today's been a success. We've walked from the bottom of the lane all the way up to the hike. We've got hundreds of signatures today. We've done really well on signatures. And I think people are getting the message.
What do you think the significance of today's event is in the fight against fracking?
Well, the public are out here and they can see all these hills here. And if they saw rigs on each one of these and fumes coming down, I think they would be pretty annoyed.
What message would you send out to people who were not quite convinced again about the campaign?
The main message would be, what are we going to do for the rest of time? Are we going to be using fossil fuels? Let's start changing things now and let's get some new energies going. There's all sorts of different energies. You know, we can use solar and we can use thermal. I think, personally, I think thermal is the big answer for most houses because you can just drill into the ground and use the energy from the ground. People are scared that we run out of gas, they can't use the boiler. But the answers are there.
What would you urge people to do in terms of joining the campaign or taking action?
Come to our meetings. That's the main one, really. We meet at the Cotton Tree every second Wednesday of the month. Come along, join in with us and get stuck in collecting signatures, making people aware, giving out these leaflets. Here, yeah, we've got plenty of leaflets that need giving out all over the country and all anywhere. So, no fracking anywhere.